Hey basketball players, today I'm going to talk to you about the low post for guards. Now this is a position that I really like for guards because of course you're not expecting a shorter player to go into the low post, and also this is kind of the position that I sort of played later on in my career. A guard who could drive on you and who can shoot very well, but who can take smaller guards in the low post. So let's get down to it. Okay, so there is sort of a science behind being a guard and being able to go into the low post. So if you are bigger than your defender, you could just drive on him like Ben Simmons does because he can't really shoot all that well. But however, if you really want to get into the head of your defender, the low post is probably the best area to do so. So as a guard, there's two different ways of being able to post up. The first way is, of course, just like a center or a low post player, you could just post them up in the low post. But generally speaking, you're not going to be able to do that because a lot of plays that your coach probably runs doesn't have you in the low post. So what you need to do is you could call an isolation. If your team doesn't already have an isolation play, you could talk to your coach about doing this. However, what you could do is, or what you can do, what I used to do a lot of, is start out near the perimeter. You get that ball, you clear the side, and now you're one-on-one against your defender. Now you could just blow by him, especially if you're bigger, you're able to protect that ball, keep it higher, keep it away from that defender. But what does that really do? That just gets your team 2 points and maybe three if you get fouled. But if you really want to hurt your defensive player mentally, this is what you do. So first off, you start out in the perimeter, or you can, I'll give you both options, but you're gonna start out in the perimeter, you're gonna get this ball. What you're gonna do now is back down your player. And I don't mean back down like dribble a half a million times, get him close to the net and score. That can work, but generally speaking, if you start doing that, you're gonna get a help defender who is actually a true center, and they're generally bigger than you. So what you really want to do is try to keep from the perimeter down to the low block, you want to keep it to 2, maximum 3 dribbles. You don't really want to go past that. Now, there is a strategy for getting assists out of this as well, so I'll get to that a bit later. But what you want to do is start out in the perimeter. And what you want to do is, as soon as you get that ball, you want to know where you're going to take this player. So what you want to do is a few different options. So you can start by taking one dribble towards the middle of the key. Now, if that's the case, and this is going to be a small step, this isn't going to be a full out running step. This is just going to be, you get the ball and you take one dribble towards the middle. Now you're seeing what that defender is going to do. So now at this point, if he tries to cut you off, put a shoulder into him. Now at this point, this left leg should be in between their left leg or their legs. And if this is the case, you need to go shoulder into the chest and then spin off of him. Now at this point, you're going to have a wide open basket, because when you do this move, if you go into him, if he cuts you off, your foot's in between his. When you put a shoulder into his chest, and I don't mean lowering the shoulder, you want to keep that shoulder over top of that foot, because this is your ground, you own this ground in basketball. When this happens and you can push him into the chest, you're going to be pushing him back onto his heels, which at this point, it's not going to be able to help or get him to allow him to be able to defend you off of the spin. So what you need to do, get that ball, one quick dribble, one short step into him. If he does try to cut you off, you need to spin and go for that layup. So it looks like this. Bang, shoulder, spin, and then you have the open basket. Now, the other option is, when you get this ball, you can then go and dribble in and turn your right side. Now, what this is doing for you is, it's going to help you be able to make that defender take your right side. Now, when this happens, obviously you're not going to be picking up this ball. When this happens, you're going to go bang, spin. If he now cuts you off on this right side and your right foot is in between his, what you need to do is, when you do that spin, you're going to go bang, bang. You're switching hands on that dribble. if your foot, a right foot, is in between their legs, you need to go shoulder into the chest again, getting them back onto the heels, and then you're gonna spin the other direction and go down the middle. So it's gonna look like this. So if you're gonna go one dribble, bang, again a second dribble, and now, and you're gonna do that a bit quicker, so you're gonna go bang, bang, and at this point, if he's come over to your right side, bump him in the chest, get him back onto his heels, spin the other direction. So you're gonna go bang, bang, hard, and then in on that right side. Now it's a little bit harder for me to overemphasize the shoulder hits, but this works extremely well. Now, you can do a full up post up from here. You can just keep on backing him down, but when you're doing that, what you wanna do is to keep your head on a swivel so that if there is a help defender that comes out on you, whether it be a center or another guard from the top, what you wanna do is to be able to find the passing lane. So, my greatest advice I can ever give you is if a defender is guarding you like this, you have four different areas you can pass: underneath his arms, and then over top of his arms beside his head. So those are passing lanes on a help defender. So you wanna come down. If you're posting him up, if you see a defender come down from the top, you need to pass out. Maybe you'll get a swing, or if not, he has an open shot. But usually what happens, if you're a guard posting up another guard, what's gonna happen is the center from down there is going to double team you on the side that you're dribbling. So if you're dribbling with your right hand, he's going to come underneath. And usually if you're dribbling with your left hand, which you should never do on the right, on this side, by the way, because if you're posting up, because now you're facing this way and you're just gonna get the ball stolen. But if you are on this side, he's gonna be popping up on that left side. So to be able to open up a couple of different lanes, you could dribble on the left side. And what I mean by that is go quick, spin, and back. And that quick left-handed switch, it might bring out that center on this side, which now you can turn this way, and you may just have a nice quick bounce pass to your own center for a layup. Now, I hope that this video has been informative to you. I hope that this video helps you if you're a bigger guard. If it has, hit that like button, subscribe. I'll see you guys again next time.